This is Hip Hop at Lunch. We're here with Mick Boogie. How's it going, man?
Great. Thanks for having me.
No problem. So congratulations on all the success you've been having, working with all these emerging artists and DJing all over the world.
Thank you.
Doing big things. So how do you meet up with these artists, like B.O.B. and you and I? Like, how'd you meet up with those guys? They, like, reach out to you, or?
It really all depends. Like, a lot of the guys, like, you know, a lot, some projects I do, they're very hands-off, but most of the projects I do now, I try to only do things that are, like, really, really hands-on. Like, the you and I guys, met them, big fans of them, we became friends, and we did a project. Same thing with other groups, like Kids in the Hall, Adonis, you know, like a lot of people like that. Like, if you see me doing a lot of consistent stuff with them, more than likely we're friends and that we have a mutual respect for each other's work and we do stuff together like that.
Okay, and when you're working with those artists like Donis and everyone, like, what's the process? Like, do you have a lot of the artistic control as well? And
when we do projects, like, with any people in that scene, it's kind of like I let them pretty much do what they want to do. But if I have suggestions or I have ideas or I don't really like something, I'll be sure I say that because my name is on it as well. And more than likely, we'll work out some sort of resolve. But a lot of times when you're working with guys like that, like the guys that you mentioned and the guys that I mentioned, everything pretty much kind of comes in perfect. But then a lot of times, you know, when I do other projects, like we did the big remix project with Peter Bjorn and John, where we took 30 different rappers and 10 different producers and kind of created a whole thing from scratch, like, yeah, that's obviously very hands-on. And that's more shaped from my perspective and my vision versus the artist, because it's just like so many different artists. You have to kind of, like, there has to be some sort of unified vision. I'm an investor partner in a really dope store called Motivation. It's based in Ann Arbor, Michigan, right on the campus of the University of Michigan. Even though I'm from Ohio, my sister went to Ohio State, so that's kind of like complicated. But it's doing really well. This week's actually our 2-year anniversary. I'm going to be out there over the weekend doing an in-store for that and doing some events surrounding that. It's dope. We're going to be expanding and franchising, and people from all over the U.S. want to open one near them. We even got somebody who reached out from, India or some, like, far away country that was talking about trying to do something. So it's kind of cool. Like, we're very, very happy. 2 years, it's been successful. And it's always great to diversify your interests too. But it all kind of falls under this, you know, it's all stuff that we live, we breathe. It's like very, you know, it's very much of us. So it's dope.
Yeah, I was going to ask about the inspiration. I guess it's just from hip-hop culture and all that, then, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's hip-hop and everything, because, I mean, like, everything is hip-hop now, you know? Like whether you listen to cool indie rock and with a little bit of hip-hop, or whether you dress up or you dress down, it's all, you know, it's all through the same vision, it's all through the same eyes, and that's kind of what we try to approach with the story.
Okay. And I've been noticing you on Twitter. You're really active. Like, how are you using it? Who are you talking to?
I mean, I guess I'm just as active as everybody else. Like, I mean, I think it's an amazing promotional tool. It's an amazing promotional opportunity to have tens of thousands of people who just want to know what you're doing at all time, and to let somebody know when you release something, I think it's really cool. Plus, it's great to get instant feedback from people. Like, do you like it? Do you not like it? Or, you know, and all, you know, it's great if you need to just know something and you don't feel like looking the shit up. Like, you send out, you know, a tweet and 29 people come back with the answer. So it's like a built-in Google right there.
What can we expect in the future? Like, are you working on anything right now?
Lots of stuff. Putting out a project next week with Tilip Kweli. He has a new group called Idol Worship, which is him and two women, Reese and Graf Nobel. Really, really, really dope, like, next level stuff. We're putting that out Monday. Lots more traveling, lots more touring, because I'm gone almost every weekend going somewhere to spend. And then during the week, I kind of just try to keep this cool. You know, I don't even really call them mixtapes anymore. They're much more like conceptual album kind of things. You know, they're beyond the scope of that. We try to, you know, work with cool people, make some cool music, and make sure people have some good stuff to listen to. It's pretty simple, really.